You're tuned into the first newscast devoted to the Highland Lakes area. Local team coverage on Tribune Headline News, bringing you the stories you care about now. Hi everyone, I'm Connie Swinney. These are your headlines on the Picayune TV. We're on Northland Communications Channel 15. Here's a look at the stories we've been working on. First, police recover two handguns after a man accidentally shoots himself in the leg. Two arrests in that case to tell you about. Marble Falls school officials come up with a creative way to keep teachers eyed for potential staffing cuts in the classrooms and on the payroll. Also, how about some relief from the sizzling sun? The Marble Falls City pool opens. We have details about the job to refurbish it and how the facility did on opening day.
Summer isn't officially here, but the summer-like weather is. I'll tell you what we can expect later in weather.
Thanks, Jared. Look forward to your report. Those stories and the latest on summer athletic camps in sports coming up.
Because experience matters. For home, auto, business, health, and life, we are here for you. When Galloway experts make top providers compete for your business, you win. The Galloway Insurance Team, since 1935. Burnet, Horseshoe Bay, and Marble Falls.
Welcome back. Police arrest two people after they find them along with another man who was shot in the leg following a low-speed chase with Marble Falls police. The incident happened just before 10 p.m. on June 1st. Police received a report of the sound of a gunshot in a Nissan sedan stopped at the intersection of Highway 281 and Ranch Road 1431. Authorities spotted the vehicle on Avenue J and followed it on a low-speed chase a few blocks before it stopped on Avenue N. Police arrested 18-year-old Veronica Fabro and 18-year-old Robert Cody James. Fabro had an arrest warrant. James was charged with evading arrest, theft of a firearm, and failure to stop at stop signs. Authorities reported a third person was found in the vehicle with an accidental gunshot wound to the leg. He was taken to Breckenridge in Austin. Police recovered two loaded .40 caliber guns from the car. In a move to avoid layoffs, Marble Falls school officials have created a permanent substitute pool made up of full-time teachers. Concerns about overstaffing led to the initiative so some teachers whose positions were at risk could stay employed, even if they're not assigned to a permanent classroom. The move is expected to save from 6 to 9 jobs. The district has reduced staff through attrition or not filling positions when educators retire or resign. Instead, they're moving staff around in the district in some cases. In the permanent substitute pool, teachers will be assigned a campus and report to the principal for daily duties. When other positions come open, teachers in the pool will be offered first dibs on the slot.
Get prepared to be swept away. We're going to tell you which team is going to be sending the waves coming up in sports.
See you in a moment, Jennifer. And we take you inside the coolest spot for kids in town. Those images coming up.
We are established. We are qualified. We are certified. We are knowledgeable. We are dependable. We are Ken's Heating and Air. Our people make the difference.
We're back. Your weather forecast starts now.
Hello, everyone. Happy Monday. To make a long story short, we're looking at highs in the mid-90s for the foreseeable future. But if you want to get into details, here's your Highland Lakes forecast for Northland Cable 15 and the Picayune TV. Monday, we've got mostly sunny skies, a high near 96, wind around 5 miles an hour. And into Monday night, partly cloudy skies, a low around 71, south wind between 5 and 10. Tuesday, much of the same, again, mostly sunny, a high near 94, south wind 5 to 10. Tuesday night, partly cloudy with a low around 71. Wednesday, again, mostly sunny skies and a high near 94 degrees. Now, I don't think I need to tell you that we're expecting more of the same looking ahead to later in the week. But yes, it looks like we'll keep those highs in the mid-90s throughout the week. If anything changes, we'll keep you posted here as the week goes on. For Northland 15 and the Picayune TV, I'm Jared Fields.
Thanks, Jared. Here's Jennifer Fierro with sports.
Come Monday, several different coaches are going to be giving tryouts or starting their first day of camp. We're going to start with the Marble Falls Tsunami Swim Team. They are going to be having their tryouts at the Marble Falls City Pool Monday at 10:30. Now, I did get a chance to talk to one of the big supporters of the Marble Falls Swim Team. That would be Parks and Recreation Director Robert Moss. Here are his thoughts about the swim team and what's coming up for them.
The swim team, I believe this is going to be the third year that we've resurrected the swim team. They've done very good. They've competed with local swim teams. They've competed with our competitors right next door in Burnett that have a huge, nice swimming pool, and we've done just as well with the facilities that we have to train in. So the swim team will probably be very popular again this year. We've had lots of calls.
Again, those tryouts are going to be at 10:30 at the Marble Falls City Pool, 305 Buena Vista. Now, we're going to turn our attention to some camps that also are going to be starting on Monday. We are talking about two different girls basketball camps. One, the Lady Dog basketball camp, directed by head coach Mike Cavender, and the other by legendary coach Jerry English. Now, Coach Cavender will be at the Burnett High School Doghouse. That camp registration is at 8 o'clock on Monday. For Coach English, his camp will be at the Faith Academy Fire Pit, also on Monday. In addition, head coach Julie Downs of the Lady Mustang volleyball team is starting her camp on Monday. And then, of course, if you want to just be out and about and you love football, head coach Doyle Walker of the Burnett High School football team will be conducting the Bulldog football camp. All of those events start on Monday. Now, we do have some additional information for people who want to know. You're welcome to contact head coach Julie Downs for the Lady Mustang volleyball camp, and she can be reached at jdowns@mfisd.txed.net. Jerry English can be contacted at coache94@verizon.net or by using his cell phone, 512-755-2794. And then, of course, call Kurt Jones for the Bulldog football camp, 830-798-7304. And then Mike Cavender can be reached at 512-756-6193. That's it for sports. I'm Jennifer Fierro. Connie, back to you.
Thanks so much, Jennifer, for that report. As we reported earlier, the pool is finally open for activities including city swim team competition and more. The nearly week-long delay was caused by a replastering project costing about $25,000 more than the city expected. The city is happy to report everything's back on track, just in time for summer's soaring temperatures. Here's Daniel Clifton with more.
Youngsters are causing quite a splash at the Marble Falls City Pool, just in time to escape from the sizzling sun.
When you live in Texas and the weather is 100 degrees every day, everybody needs a place to cool off. It's a safe environment for kids and it's cool.
Temperatures have soared near triple digits for the past few days, but up until Thursday, youngsters like these had to look for cool waters elsewhere, even as school let out in Marble Falls May 27th. It was all because the contract workers for the city of Marble Falls found a much bigger than expected job after draining the pool to repaint and clean it. An even more unexpected cost of $25,000 to $30,000 for the task. But by June 2nd, the 4,100 square foot pool was refilled and ready to go. Features include 3 to 11 feet deep levels, a diving board and cover tables. Crews also uncovered and refurbished racing lanes.
There was a little bit of a delay for starting our swim team this year, but we're going to start Monday with tryouts at 10:30 in the morning right here. So we're excited.
And every bit as excited are those who now have the chance to find their oasis in the sun.
Most people get really bored in the summertime and hot. And so it's a great place to have fun, you know, with your family and stuff.
Reporting for the Picayune TV, I'm Daniel Clifton.
Marble Falls City officials counted 100 people in attendance at the pool on opening day. The swimming pool is open from 1 to 6 in the afternoons, 7 days a week through August 1st. The price, $2 for children, $3 for those 13 and older. You can check out the number on your screen, that's the Marble Falls Parks and Recs Department, to rent the pool for weekend morning parties. Those were your headlines. Thanks so much for watching. For the Picayune TV, I'm Connie Swinney.